Everyone loves a good party, and your wedding day will likely be the biggest party you'll ever throw, which means it's a good idea to start planning right away. As our next guest will tell you, there are plenty of things to get done in the early stages of planning your big day. Katie Murphy and Ashley Anderson are with Jane Ray Events, and they're here with some advice to help the brides-to-be out there get into planning mode. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
So first, I just want to start off, Katie, by talking about it's engagement season, but then after you get engaged, how long on average do people normally wait, or how long do you recommend people wait before setting their wedding date?
Sure, so we recommend planning at least a year out, just because a lot of the vendors that you may want, they're booked up before that. So it creates some stress when you have to go to vendor one and then two and three and hear that they're always booked. So we recommend a year or even more than that.
And some people have in mind what they want already anyways before they even get engaged.
Oh, they just
have it all planned out, bridesmaids, dresses, everything. But planning this on your own can get stressful, and this is a big day. So what are the benefits for hiring a planner?
Sure. So hopefully it's the first time that you're doing this. And so it's really hard to know, like, where to even begin. And we have planned so many weddings, and so we know the steps that you should take, and we kind of lead you through that process, and it just brings down the stress because you're not supposed to know what to do. And so we have, we can lead you right through, and a lot of stress comes from who to go to and taking the time to review those people, and we can cut that time down.
So Ashley, as an event planner, helping brides plan this big day, what are the most things that are forgotten? If I was doing this on my own, there's probably some little things that I wouldn't even think I needed to plan for.
Yeah, so I think oftentimes we find this in meetings when we're chatting with brides, we kind of have this form that we go through and just talk through every area. So ceremony, reception, how are we getting from point A to point B if there's a transition like that? And so I think oftentimes they say at the end of the meeting, oh my gosh, you brought up so many things that I wasn't thinking of. And a lot of times those are those little details like, what time should I start my ceremony? If I want my guests to not have a super long wait time during cocktail hour while my friends and I are transitioning. And so that's kind of a big one. And then another one is, you know, what vendors specifically, caterers, all of that sort of thing. There's some big ones that you think of, but there are little ones that you miss too, like stationery, that sort of thing.
So as an event planner too, having one of these available to you, you help everything from the beginning up to the big day, but then also on the big day, how do you play a role in that?
Yeah, it depends for sure what our brides hire us for, but I would say a big majority do want that setup, tear down, the help on the day. It's huge, right? You don't want your family having to run around like crazy. And so we get to come in morning of, set everything up, just like we talked about, just like you wanted. And then we're oftentimes there all day to kind of make sure everything's happening like seamlessly. And then we are there at the end of the night to tear it all down. So you just get to go home and enjoy.
Make it a little less stressful.
Yeah.
All right, Katie, so let's talk about a very, very important piece of this, the guest list.
Yes.
Even just thinking about this, I'm not even engaged and it gives me anxiety. How do you make your guest list? Who do you invite?
Sure. So you have to start with, your intermediate family. So the obvious, you know, your parents, grandparents, siblings, and then expand from there, like your aunts, uncles, cousins, you know, just the family that you are close to and you feel like has to be there to complete your day. And then, of course, friends as well. I think kind of a good rule of thumb, if you haven't, you know, hung out with them or talked to them in the past, like, couple years, they probably don't need to be there at your wedding. And I know that gets hard, and you can't make everybody happy. It's impossible to just invite everyone. But that is one thing to decide on if you want a really big wedding or if you want something more intimate. That's a good question to ask yourself at the beginning.
And then do you give every guest a plus one?
I think so. I think just sitting in that guest shoes, if they didn't have a plus one, weddings are all about like being with somebody, you know, so it's nice to have somebody there with you to enjoy it.
And when should I be considering who I'm going to put on this guest list? How early in the process?
As soon as you want to start planning. So I would say it's one of the first things, hire a planner and then talk about your guest list, just because it affects everything as far as budget goes, your venue, catering, every vendor, it really does kind of put, an effect on. So,
yeah, let's talk about the vendor, venue, where we're going to be. So when you're doing this, Ashley, what are some things that, because people may have their dream location of where they've always wanted to go, but there's some things that could change this for them. So how do you help assist in someone picking their venue?
Yeah, so first thing we kind of ask them is that guest count. So that can be a little restrictive if you have a guest list of 400, right? Like, not every venue can hold that many people. So that's the first question. And then the second is, what's your theme? So what's the feel of your day? Are you more rustic? Are you more modern? Kind of classic, romantic? All of those things can kind of fall into the venue category too. I'm sure you've heard of all the barn venues popping up. Just so great. They're all a little bit different in their own way. And so we recommend those a lot. Or if you want to be more downtown, we have a lot of great venues downtown Sioux Falls too. So it really depends on like what someone is looking for to kind of match the feel of their day.
Now, I have to ask too, because it is the Roaring 20s. Yeah. It's a big year. So are you seeing a lot of people go with that theme, Katie?
We actually haven't. I mean, maybe later on in the year, this winter, they will kind of go with that theme a little bit. But we haven't really seen that come in, the feathers and stuff like that yet. Maybe it will later.
Yeah. Still, either way, whether or not you do that theme, it's still a great year to get married.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right. Well, thank you so much, ladies, for coming in, giving us all of these tips and advice to hopefully take out the stress from planning for some of these brides.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.